Welcome back to The Generation Y with me, Scott Sinjeta Keita. The hashtag is The Generation Y. We're talking about leadership. Make sure you feel free to just join the conversation on all social media platforms and we'll always get back to you. Yes, now, Victor, before we had gone on break, we just mentioned entrepreneurship and how it's providing a solution to the big problem of unemployment, which is, of course, affecting most young people in Africa and, of course, in Kenya. In Nairobi, of course, if you want to become specific, many young people out there are hustling, you know, trying to get their businesses afloat and everything. How is YALDA supporting this movement of entrepreneurship, supporting this school of thought of you do not need to have a day job, you do not need to have a white-collar job, you can go out there and create those jobs?
I will repeat that YALDA creates that forum, it creates that avenue, because having developed a name now, we can approach organizations, or rather organizations can approach us, and when we share ideas, or rather when the organizations invite us to some seminars of some sort, we get to learn from experts, we get to learn from successful entrepreneurs, That's the way that YALDA does it. That's how YALDA
does
it.
Just creating those platforms.
Creating those avenues,
Amazing. Now, coming back again to leadership, a lot of negative ethnicity is going around right now in the media, in social media platforms. We're seeing leaders just becoming very loose with their words. What is YALDA doing, any sort of campaign it's doing to just try and solve this issue, try and develop a platform where young leaders can come and change the whole status quo?
Negative ethnicity has become so much. It's become a big problem for our country. And at the moment, no campaigns really, but we are thinking about such really, because it's something that's eating the Kenyan society so much. But what I would say, it's the simple things that we do. And as a leader, or the many leaders that I lead, we have in our structures, our framework is such that we work in committees. And personally, I'm as keen in little details, like when I'm sending some delegation for a conference, maybe actually having a conference at this moment. Yeah, in Strathmore University. So whenever I'm sending a delegation, personally, I'm usually keen in looking at I'm representing Kenya equally.
Exactly. You not
like
ha-
I'll not have mm-hmm. I'll not have just
your
my kinsmen
eh,
going.
No.
Yeah, and that's bad.
And it's something that has been really embraced by Kenyan leaders. To an extent, there's no shame about it. You know, you can just employ your brother, your sister to work under your department without any shame or fear. What do you think would be the right way? What do you think young leaders should do to change the whole thing?
Yeah, we should be conscious that we are all equal.
Exactly.
And that we deserve equal opportunities. So it will be so inhumane to deny someone a chance.
Just because of where they come
just
from.
Just because of where they come from. It's really sad. It's something that should be an abomination. Personally, it's an abomination for me. And if someone, I do things by merit, and I've always influenced the people around me to accept it that way, that merit should work.
Should be the gauge.
Yeah.
Exactly, exactly, amazing. Now, coming back to just what you mentioned, the Strathmore conference that is going on, what's that all about?
The conference is again about Africa. Yeah, we have our partners, World Youth Alliance, who invited us to the conference.
Amazing.
And we have YALDA members who are also members of the World Youth Alliance. It's no harm, because like World Youth Alliance is particular about human dignity and all over the world. So they have their regional office in Nairobi, and having worked with them before, we were well informed about the conference, and we saw no need not to attend. So we are having like 10 of our elder members representing us in a delegation of African young people.
Amazing, amazing. Yeah. What has been the main challenge of just setting up that platform under YALDA, mm-hmm. especially for you being the executive director? What has been the main challenge of just keeping things going, running the whole organization and making sure everything is working, every youth out there, every youth leader is getting that platform to be recognized as a leader and to express themselves? What challenges have been there?
Yeah, at campus we have small issues like people thinking
this is a
organization are money minting.
Of
yeah?
course, yeah.
They just
yeah.
want that registration fee from mm-hmm. them mm-hmm. and that has not been the case. Personally, when I'm inviting people to YALDA, I just tell them that you come to YALDA, stay there for like even a month. Then if you see that your membership is if you think that YALDA deserves your membership, then you just have to pay the little fee that you pay for it.
Which of course keeps things running.
Yeah, which keeps some few things running. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Amazing. Yeah. What would you identify as some of the biggest challenges that campus guys are facing right now?
The biggest challenge that you're facing is that there is so much emphasis on education and actually not education but getting a job, and that's really what is
so after coming out of campus, guys are getting
someone is just wants to blindly drop CVs everywhere
and hopefully get a call back somewhere.
Yeah, exactly.
Wow.
Blindly, unfortunately. Mm-hmm. You did not hear of any application, but you just dropped a CV somewhere.
Wow.
So I would say that is it, and that's why we should now consider entrepreneurship, mm-hmm. because campus provides us with the skill.
Mm-hmm.
So why not
use those skills?
And I would urge, or rather I would dare my fellow African youth to dream.
Mm-hmm.
And that's just what is lacking. If we just dreamt, and it will cost you nothing to dream.
Mm-hmm.
It will cost you something
mm-hmm.
to fulfill your dream, but it will cost you nothing to dream.
It's
yeah.
true, it's true. Now let's also touch a bit on, of course, YALDA dealing with development and youth leadership,
mm-hmm.
the SDGs that have just been introduced by the United Nations.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think they have in store, especially for young leaders and, of course, the young populace that is the African population?
I think the SDGs, and we should have noticed that they are more in number now than the
MDGs, yeah.
which were 8.
Mm-hmm.
And what I would say, the SDGs from the word sustainable, they are meant to have the goals that we had, and we've achieved them partly sustained into the future.
Mm-hmm.
And like when you're talking about eradication of poverty, governments, authorities have been keen on that.
Mm-hmm.
So I think with such issues like entrepreneurship
mm-hmm.
now brought into picture,
yeah
Africans or the entire world, but now African, which is home,
mm-hmm.
the young people
mm-hmm.
should embrace this entrepreneurship animal that
it's
they've
true.
Been
it's true.
They've been running
to.
Away from.
I
yeah,
know, I know.
Exactly.
And again, just on the subject matter of development, how do you think ICT will play into the future of development and, of course, leadership?
ICT
mm-hmm.
is a gold mine,
mm-hmm.
I would say,
mm-hmm.
and with very, I don't know, astounding
mm-hmm.
Technological innovations that happen each and every minute.
Amazing.
We should
yeah,
try and capture into
mm-hmm.
that and actually make them an entrepreneurship hub, and where young people will get much from
and
it.
it's quite amazing seeing
yeah.
all these like the iHub coming
mm-hmm.
up,
exactly.
the NILab, all these
mm-hmm.
platforms
mm-hmm.
where
mm-hmm.
entrepreneurs can be.
Yeah.
Can
at campus, we have the C4D Lab.
Amazing. C4D
yeah.
Lab, what's that about?
Yeah, it's just like iHub.
Uh-huh.
It's a lab where innovations
can be
mature.
Grown and everything.
Yeah, we actually have a member who is trying to develop some application.
Wow, amazing things.
Yeah.
Of course, going into the future, we know that YALDA, in partnership with all these organizations,
yeah.
is going to do great stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, unfortunately, that's all the time we could have for here on the Generation Y. And remember, of course, if you want to be part of YALDA, remember what to do. You can always tweet Mr. Victor Gesora at Gesora
Okero.
Okero. Make sure you engage with him in very informative conversations, and he'll always give you directions on how to be part of the movement. And of course, here at the Generation Y, you know what to do. Go to our Facebook page. The hashtag is the Generation Y. Always keep us engaged in any discussion that is coming up, any leadership venture that you feel that like you want to be part of. This is the place to engage in such discussions. Thank you so much for watching The Generation Y. We'll see you on the next one. You've been watching The Generation Y with me, Scott Njetane Keita. See you next time.